auditorium Saturday and Friday night at 8 o'clock. Tickets are $4 in advance and $5 at the door. Now we would like to show you some clips of the play and hope you like it.
High School. I would like to invite you all to come out Friday and Saturday night at 8 o'clock to see our production of Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. You can get advance tickets from any cast member, or you can call Anna Whittle at 537-8563. It'll be $5 at the door, but come and enjoy. It's good for all ages. Bring your family. We will be glad to perform for you. See you later.
Thank you. sneak preview of Cinderella. The show runs Saturday night, and starts at 8 o'clock, and tickets at the door are $5.
Thank you. Christopher Rupert, William Vladimir, Carl Alexander, Francois Reginald, and
our shopping tour today. How about the most beautiful materials with all the you marry the prince,
you both must marry somebody this year.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, there's one thing you must remember. When you want to marry a man, you can't rely on your beauty alone. Now, Portia, you are named for a great lawyer. I want you to show off your intellect as well as your beauty. Do you understand?
Naturally.
Enjoy. I want you to live up to your name. I want you to be vivacious and alert as well as beautiful.
Uh-huh.
That does not mean, however, that I want you to neglect your appearance. Our family has always been noted for its most fascinating women. So now, let's all go upstairs and get our beauty sleep. Oh, I'm so exhausted from all that shopping. Oh, tomorrow I'm going to have to get a massage. So that's the only thing that does me any good, a good pounding. Well, that's what your father used to say.
Well, I'm all tired out too, Mother. Going from store to store the way we did. You're tired. Yes, I'm tired. I suppose you think you're the only one that's tired. Well, who bought the most? That has nothing to do with it. That has everything to do with it.
Go to bed, both of you.
Leave me alone. You're always picking on me, Mother.
That's right. Don't raise your voices. And you, don't stand there gaping at me. Tidy up those tea things.
Stepmother?
What is it now?
I was wondering about the ball. All the other women in the kingdom are invited.
And I suppose you think that the prince is going to take one look at you and fall madly in love?
Why, kidding me?
Take my advice, Cinderella. Be satisfied with what you've got. I promise you, you'll be much happier.
I wonder why they're so tired of looking at all those beautiful things and buying so many of them. I was too excited to be tired. Oh, I love this room when they've all gone out and there's no one here but me.
Cinderella!
Yes, ma'am?
Stop joking around now, Lily. You know, we can't sleep for the rabbit.
Yes, ma'am. I'm just going to sit down anyway.
Mother, stop and speak as a mouth. When I hear
interest in anything or anyone.
Oh, he's happy, all right.
If he's happy, why doesn't he get married?
If he's happy, why should he get married?
Look at your belt.
How could I gain so much weight in 5 years?
Because that's all you've done for 5 years is to gain weight. You haven't had more of a poor costume because we haven't given a ball for 5 years. You've done nothing to give yourself this any fun. Not a festival, not a fair, not even a pageant. You've done nothing to make your people love you.
Ah, but they do anyway. Don't they?
We'll just have to get the royal girl to make you another suit.
But that'll cost money.
Don't start to worry about what you're going to pay the tailor. Wait till you see what this ball is going to cost.
Maisie, this is no time to splurge. The extra core is low and I can't afford.
I have the chef in the store waiting outside to get the plans for the dinner.
The dinner?
Certainly, you cannot give a ball without a dinner.
I don't have something to hear.
That door involved.
money giving with my money.
Oh, that. Well, to tell you the truth, sir, it's not that I'm looking forward to. Dancing with all those candidates.
Candidates?
Every simpering girl in the kingdom. Each one determined to prove to me that she is the perfect princess for me.
Yes, I know how you feel. More fun to chase one than to be stampeded by a whole bandit.
One thing's for sure, whoever I marry will be anyone I meet in the fall.
Yes, I know how you feel, my boy. But there's one thing you mustn't forget. Your mother's got a heart set on giving you some fare.
Yes, I know.
Christopher, if you talk to your mother, tell her that. Tell her that you love the idea. Make her feel good about it, you know what I mean? And some other stuff I'm going to tell you was, oh, hello, dear. Christopher and I were at...
I was just saying, Mother, how much I'm looking forward to the ball. It sounds wonderful.
Does it?
Yes, and I was wondering if I could help you at all. I mean, with any of the preparations.
Well, yes, dear, maybe you can.
And I see they're bringing my horses around from the stable now.
Have you got the sniffles? Getting a cold? Better take something for it. Don't want to have red nose at the ball.
I'll be over it by then.
Maybe.
What?
That boy isn't unhappy.
How do you know?
I asked him. He said he's feeling fine.
Did he? Yes. You know something?
What?
I love you.
Naturally you do. I'm the king.
Nothing to do with it.
Such as that. is the day of the ball.
Is. You're a nice-eyed child, but wonderful things. I wish you believed that once in a while something marvelous and magical can happen.
Oh, I wouldn't say that I don't believe that once in a while something marvelous and magical can happen.
For instance, you believe in guardian angels?
Well, I can't say that I don't believe in them. Only thing is, it's dangerous to believe too much in good fairies and guardian angels.
Why?
Oh, you get to lean on them too much. You get in the habit of sitting back and expecting them to do all the work for you. You've got to help yourself, you know.
I know. I think about it a lot. But then I don't know what to do. So I always wind up just wishing and dreaming. Not sure that that does any good at all.
Well, I wouldn't say it doesn't do any good at all. Everything has to start with a wish. Nothing happens without wishing.
Do you know what I was wishing tonight?
The moment before you came? Here.
You see that pumpkin in the yard?
I nearly stumbled over it in the dark.
I was wishing that pumpkin would turn into a great, big, royal, golden carriage that would carry me to the ball tonight.
And what were you going to do for horses?
White mice. Two white mice would turn into horses. Beautiful white, prancing steeds.
And were you going to drive them yourself?
Oh no, there'd be a coachman and a footman.
And where were they coming from?
They'd be the two baby rats I saw down in the cellar yesterday. I know what you're going to say. Boulder roller, fiddly-dee.
Yes, boulder roller, fiddly-dee.
It's impossible, I suppose.
Impossible.
Just the same, it was what I was wishing. I'm still wishing it.
Nonsense.
I'm wishing it very hard.
You are?
Yes, I am. Only I could have some magical help. Only I had a guardian angel. My godmother, or fairy godmother.
Ha! Good joke. Very funny.
I'm wishing in the name of every young girl who ever wanted to go to a dance and was told that she couldn't. I'm wishing that I make good at that dance tonight. I wish that by some kind of magic or abracadabra, fold a roll of fiddly-dee, all the kind hearts in the world will put their heads together.
All the kind hearts put their heads together?
You know what I mean. All the kind hearts and good souls will wish with me that you, Godmother, will help me with every ounce of cleverness and strength you possess.
Cinderella?
Yes?
It's impossible.
Impossible. I'm so
sorry. Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for a plain country pumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And two white mice will never be two white horses.
Thank you.
hurry. The ball will be over before you get there.
Thank you. Thank you. It's wonderful.
Now, you must go in and do exactly as I told you.
You mean you're not coming in with me?
Heavens no. I've been to so many of these things, I couldn't stand another. Furthermore, all I can do is give you your wish. How it turns out this year, up to you.
But I'm afraid to go in there all by myself.
You needn't be, except for one thing. Do not stay beyond 12 o'clock. See that you are in the coach and off for home before the clock strikes 12.
Why is it so important that I leave before 12?
You just obey and don't ask any questions.
Godmother.
Easily turn to Portia. The school arrives, Billy, of Portia.
Now look what, she's beginning to look better.
I wonder who she is. All of a sudden he is a different boy. His face is lined up, he is handsome when he's swinging himself.
Sing him down to that lovely creature. You know where it takes me back to?
To where?
The first time I danced with you, my love.
I wonder who she is.
I wonder who she is.
Little bubble with a whimsy kind of charm, and with every very trouble,
horrible. It's too crowded.
Much nicer out here.
Yes, it is. The moon beating down on us. What's the matter?
I must go.
Why?
I promised my godmother.
Your godmother will forgive you if you're a little late.
Oh, no, she won't. You don't understand. I have a strange kind of godmother.
Strange kind of girl. You haven't yet told me your name.
It's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Of course I would. Whatever your call is, the most beautiful name in the world. Whatever your name is, I love you. I'll always love you. You don't say anything. I just told you I love you. You don't say anything.
I'm afraid I might wake up.
Are you sure you're asleep?
Oh, yes.
And are you dreaming that I'm about to kiss you? Strange how things happen. A girl I never saw before comes down a flight of stairs. My whole life has changed. Suddenly I'm in a different world. I'm deeply in love. Yet, I don't know why I'm in love, do you? What did you think I meant?
I thought you meant, so I know why I'm in love.
Well, do you? I mean, are you?
Oh, yes.
And do you know why?
No, I don't care why.
I always want to know why I do anything. Why I feel anything. So I ask myself, why you, a stranger? You're the only girl I could ever love. You're the only one of your kind. Why? What's the sound of your voice, the sweetest sound in the world? What is the color of your hair, the only color a girl's hair should be? Why would I rather hold you in my arms than do anything else in the world? Why?
Hush, Your Highness.
Christopher.
Hush, Christopher. That's the way you feel.
Why do I feel that way? What makes you so miraculous?
Your imagination.
What makes my imagination so miraculous?
Thank you. Thank you.
this is so.
Thank you.
belongs to her.
But what are you going to do about it?
Sir, may I have the Royal Guards to send out through the kingdom in search of her?
Of course you may.
And your Secret Service, may I call them in to help me?
They never find out anything, but you're welcome to use it.
I will try everything. I will search every inch of the kingdom for the owner of the slipper.
That is what I would. Well, I would.
See that this slipper has drowned every young maiden in the kingdom, no matter how unlikely she looks. You are to keep on trying to find one that fits. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Find that girl.
I will go and speak with my chief of staff.
Chris, how do you don't find her?
I must find her.
This whole outline, you knew nothing about her. You know nothing about her now, just that she's dancing and that she loves her.
I know she's the loveliest thing on earth, and I'll never be happy without her.
Why do you think that?
I don't know why. I don't expect you to understand.
But Chris, I do understand. I know it doesn't take long for you to feel this way about this girl. But there's one fact that you must say. You may never see her again. I don't want you to waste your life on a dream. I want you to be in love with a real girl.
She is real.
She was real last night. If she doesn't come back, she won't be real again, will she? Chris, be honest with yourself. Does your future happiness really depend upon you finding her? Or are you just telling yourself that? Don't be angry with me. Think over what I'm saying. Ask yourself if this is not just an illusion or an infatuation with something that doesn't exist at all.
You're out there. Somewhere. I don't know where. Said last night you thought we were dreaming. Maybe you were right. My mother is right. How can I tell? How can one ever tell?
A girl to find.
I'm sure I've seen you somewhere, or at least someone who resembles you. Do you have any sisters by any chance?
Two, Your Highness.
These sisters, do they work at the palace?
No, Your Highness.
Are they stepsisters?
Yes, Your Highness.
Oh.
Is there anything the matter?
Scandal, a foolish dream. Dream that never came true by a glass slipper. It wouldn't fit anyway.
You mustn't give up hope.
It was a waste of time. A wild goose chase. It was impossible.
Your Highness, possible things are happening every day.
Believe in foolish dreams?
Wish hard enough. Believe in what you're wishing. It's impossible to make it come true.
Why do I feel like it? Or am I just imagining it? Who are you?
I'm just a girl from the village. I'm this girl my stepmother will be wondering.
Your stepmother wouldn't mind if you're a little late. Mind if you're a little late.
I'm a strange kind of stepmother.
Strange kind of stepmother.
No, Your Highness, I must go.
Yes, I suppose you must.
Bye, Your Highness.
Yes. Goodbye. Wait. At least tell me your name.
That's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Silly name. Like
it. Silly, Your Highness, I must go.
Wait, has anyone tried to slip on you?
No, Your Highness.
I've found you. And I still don't even know your name.
My name is Cinderella.
Most beautiful name in the world.